Okay, assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So as promised, this video will be presenting the full wave rectifier, and we are going to discuss two types of full wave rectifier: the center-tapped rectifier and the bridge rectifier. So the first one is the full wave rectification circuit using center-tapped transformer. So it is called center-tapped because the transformer is being tapped at the center in the secondary part of your transformer. Okay, but the value here is still the secondary voltage VS, and this is also secondary voltage VS. So please do not divide by 2 or do anything else, because you are still going to use the same formula, which is V primary over V secondary. So I know that in this figure it shows VI, but actually it's your V primary, yeah? Okay, so I'm just going to replace it here in this figure. Okay, so as I mentioned just now, you are going to calculate VS using the equation VP over VS equivalent to the ratio N1 over N2, just like your half-wave rectifier. Okay, so during the positive cycle of the secondary voltage, the polarity of your VS will be as follows. Okay, so the current would want to flow from this positive terminal, okay, and therefore your diode D1 will be fault bias, okay, and because your D2 is connected to your negative terminal here, okay, so of course your D2 will be reverse bias. So the diode will be turned on and the current will flow from this positive terminal through your R and then to the negative terminal or ground. Okay, so just like what I have explained in half wave, if we are dealing with model 2 or model 3 of your diode, okay, so D1 will turn on when VS reaches V gamma at an angle theta 1, and once it reaches theta 2, your D1 will turn off again. Okay, so as I mentioned just now, your current will flow in this direction. Okay, so because current flows this way, the polarity of your output voltage will be like this, yeah? Right. So now, during negative cycle, the polarity of your VS will be in this notation. The positive terminal now is at the bottom. Okay, you invert it. Alright. So, of course, now D1 will be reverse bias because connected to negative terminal. And D2 this time will be forward bias. Alright. So, similarly, D2 will turn on when the magnitude of VS reaches V gamma at an angle, this time you're going to refer to as theta 3. Okay, theta 3, and then turn off when it reaches theta 4. For this time, we label this theta 3 and theta 4 because the diode turns on during negative cycle. So it's a different angle. Okay, so that's why it is called theta 3 and theta 4. I will show you where it is in the next slide. So now the current will flow in this way, from D2 up here, but it cannot go to D1 because it's reverse bias, so it has to go to the right, go down your resistor, and then back to the negative terminal. Have a look at the current direction here, and polarity of Vout is the same, okay, during positive cycle and negative cycle. So that's why it is called a full wave rectifier, because the rectification process occurs during negative cycle and positive cycle. Okay, so in order to derive the equation for the output voltage, let's consider the first case, which is during the positive cycle, where your D2 is off. So you can see I have removed D2 here, and your D1 is on. So if I do my KVL at this loop, okay, so I will get Vout minus Vs plus Vd. And then you can rearrange, okay, so this is the equation just now. So you can rearrange in order to get Vout equivalent to Vs minus Vd. Similarly, for the negative cycle, where your D1 is off, so I have removed D1 here, and this time your D2 is on, you will get, so if I start from this point, it's Vout minus Vs plus Vd, alright? And you will get the same output equation during positive cycle and negative cycle. Okay, as I have mentioned just now, there are four angles that relates to full wave rectifier because the output occurs during both cycles. So you can see here all these angles occurs where Vs is equal or bigger than V gamma, which is the turn on voltage of the diode. So theta 1 and theta 2 are points during the positive cycle, while theta 3 and theta 4 are points during negative cycle. So during negative cycle, the area where Vs is bigger than V gamma is this area. Okay, so basically I am referring to the magnitude. Don't worry about the negative sign because we already deal with that when we inverted the terminals for your Vs during negative cycle. So we already deal with the negative sign. So now theta 3 can be calculated by using this equation. Okay, theta 3 is equivalent to 180 plus theta 1. So as for theta 4, it can be calculated using 360 minus theta 1. Okay, so as long as you can get theta 1, you can calculate the other angles, theta 2, theta 3, and theta 4, right? So now I would like to present to you on how to derive the peak inverse voltage or the maximum reverse bias voltage for center-tapped rectifier. Now, in your center-tapped circuit, whenever one of the diode is off, there will be another diode that will be turned on, and because of that, Vout will always have a value. So if I want to find out the VR, okay, for diode D1 over here, okay, so I'm going to use KVL at the loop here. So I will start at this point, minus VR plus Vout plus VS peak. Okay, so this Vout, okay, is the value because your D2 is on. So that's why we have a Vout equation, we have a Vout value here. So because we want to find the maximum reverse bias voltage, we straight away use Vs peak, and therefore even for your Vout, the equation is Vs minus Vd, right? So we just straight away use Vs peak minus Vd. So the maximum reverse bias voltage for your diode in a center-tapped circuit is 2 Vs peak minus Vd. So that's how you derive the PIV for this diode. So even if you use the condition when your D1 is on and your D2 is off, you will get the same equation. Okay, I'm just showing to you how to derive it using this loop because it is easier to demonstrate by using this loop. Okay, so in both conditions, whether D1 is off or D2 is off, you will get VR equivalent to 2 Vs peak minus Vd. Okay, so next we will cover about the bridge rectifier circuit. So you can see here in the circuit diagram, four diodes are arranged in the form of a bridge. So that is why it is called a bridge rectifier circuit. So similarly, your Vs is going to be calculated using the formula Vp over Vs equivalent to the ratio of the transformer. So during the positive cycle, similarly, the polarity of your Vs will be as follows. And you can see here the current will flow from this positive terminal through D1, through your R, and then D2 back to the negative terminal. So two diodes will turn on during each cycle. So now, as for the negative cycle, again, we will invert the polarity of your secondary voltage. So now the current will flow from this point. Okay, so the diodes that will turn on are D4, and then it will go through your R, and then D3. Okay, so similarly to your center tap, you can see here, yeah, the current flows the same way during both cycles, resulting in the same polarity of your output voltage. So next, let's derive the output equation for your bridge rectifier. So let's consider the first case, which is during the positive cycle. So you can see here, D1 and D2 conducts, while D3 and D4 are off. So I have removed D3 and D4. So let's derive the output equation. I will start from this point. So Vd plus Vout plus Vd minus Vs. So when you rearrange, you can see the output Vout equivalent to Vs minus 2 Vd. Next is the negative cycle. So I have already inverted the secondary voltage here. So the current will flow from this point. So at this cycle, D3 and D4 are on, while D1 and D2 are reverse bias. So I have removed these two diodes. So to derive the output equation, I'll start from here. Vd plus Vout plus Vd minus Vs. And you will get the same equation as your positive cycle. Vout equivalent to Vs minus 2Vd. Okay, so you can see here, because the current has to go through two diodes at each cycle, the peak value of your output voltage will be lower, yeah? Because you are going to minus 2V gamma in the equation of your output voltage. Unlike your center tap and half wave, where you only minus V gamma, so the peak value for your output voltage will be lower by a value of 2V gamma here. Okay, so similar to center tap, there are four angles associated with the full wave. So you have the theta 1 here, theta 2, theta 3 and theta 4. So these angles all occur when your Vs equal or bigger than V gamma. So the calculation for your theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 and theta 4 have been covered in your center tap rectifier just now. So you may refer to the earlier section of this video. So next, I will talk about the PIV for your bridge rectifier. So now, in order to derive the PIV for bridge rectifier, so I will choose the condition where D3 and D4 are on, while D1 and D2 are off, which occurs during the negative cycle. Now, similar to center tap, there will always be an output voltage during each cycle, because in both conditions, two diodes will turn on. Okay, so again, Vout will have a value. So this is the direction of D1, which is off. So I have to put Vr in this notation. And this one is for D2, which is also turned off during this negative cycle. And this is how we put the reverse bias voltage for D2. Okay, so if I choose this loop in order to derive the PIV, okay, so I'll start with this point here, minus Vr plus Vout, minus Vr again plus Vs, and same thing because I want to know the maximum reverse bias voltage. Straight away, I take the Vs peak, and Vout here is because of the two diodes turned on, D3 and D4, so there is an output voltage equation, and the equation for Vout is Vs minus 2Vd, and because I want to calculate the maximum value, we use the Vs peak as well for your output voltage. So as you rearrange this equation, you will get the PIV for bridge rectifier will be Vs peak minus Vd. So that's how you can derive the PIV for bridge rectifier. And again, doesn't matter if you derive it when D1 and D2 are on and D3 and D4 are off, you will get the same answer. Vr equivalent to Vs peak minus Vd. So basically, here is the summary for your PIV. So for half wave, the PIV is the peak value of your secondary voltage. For the center tap, we have derived just now, it's 2 Vs peak minus Vd. And for full wave bridge rectifier, the PIV is Vs peak minus Vd. So this is the PIV for the standard rectifier circuits. So finally, to calculate the duty cycle for full wave rectifier is very easy. Remember, when you derive the duty cycle for your half wave, what you need to do is just multiply by 2. And so you will get the duty cycle for a full wave rectifier. So maybe I will present another video where we can do some examples for these two type of full wave rectifiers. But at the moment, this is what you need to know for your assessment. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye. Assalamualaikum.